It's my great pleasure to speak this afternoon. First of all, please allow me to express my sincere appreciation for your active participation in this year's Creative Economy 2021 Forum to advance Malaysia's creative economy. I also like to congratulate my creative ventures, Cendana and Rioch, for putting together this timely and groundbreaking forum to rally everyone behind the goal to reimagine the creative arts and cultural industries. COVID-19, as you know, has severely impacted the creative industry, which has been experiencing cash flow constraints due to income loss or deferred projects, as well as the need for rapid support in rebooting some of the creative activities. So, ladies and gentlemen, the creative industries accounted for approximately 1.9% of GDP in 2015. This contribution has enormous potential to grow and contribute significantly to Malaysia's economy in the long term. The challenge for all parties concerned, including the government, is how do we capitalize on this foundation and what measures must we put in place so that the creative economy can become a substantial and sustainable contributor to the nation. To start off with, we need to dispel the illusion that the various economic sectors exist in isolation and point to the fact that our creative economy has a synergistic relationship with the wider Malaysian economy. A clear example of such a relationship can be seen in South Korea, where the success of film and music industries helped boost the global sales of beauty products, electronics, and promoted their tourism industry to the world. With the right approach, our creative economy as well could make vital contributions to high growth sectors and industries such as technology and communications, science and innovation, commerce, and even education. To ensure the immediate survival during the COVID-19 pandemic, 225 million ringgit was allocated by the government for the arts, culture, entertainment, and even an event industries under Penjana. This includes 100 million ringgit in soft loans and 30 million ringgit in grants for the creative events and exhibitions under the My Creative Ventures, as well as 10 million ringgit under Cendana. Ladies and gentlemen, some of the sessions of today's forum featured seasoned creative practitioners who shared how they successfully pivoted to not only survive, but thrive in the new normal. It is important for us to inculcate the idea that all businesses must be ready to pivot and evolve. Yeah? This is a new paradigm where even the disruptors are themselves being disrupted. Creative arts and cultural industries practitioners should no longer see themselves in isolation. This is a time when disciplines and values of businesses are being integrated through digital and other technological means. So consider this for a moment. How influential would the global tech giants like Google, Apple, and Amazon be if they did not have its creative economy content on their platforms? The creative economy has, in fact, become the competitive edge and growth determiner of so many high growth companies around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, regionally, there's been a clear shift in the region as we see countries like Thailand, Indonesia, and South Korea successfully growing and promoting their creative economies. The creative economy is also an opportunity for us to promote our Malaysian art, culture, heritage, and creativity on the world stage. This time, we add our own success story by creating a sustainable, resilient, and thriving creative economy that will help grow and promote Malaysia internationally. We often feel a sense of pride whenever we hear names such as Dr. Jimmy Choo, Tan Sri Michelle Yeoh, Adele Lim, Yuna, Tan Tuan Eng, and many more who have cemented their presence on the global stage. However, we need to do more to empower talents across the entire creative economy and also to step forward and make our nation proud. In addressing the challenges in healthcare, and the economy posed by the spread of COVID-19, the Malaysian government has crafted and implemented its six-stage recovery strategy. The nation is now at the fifth stage, which is to revitalize the economy. Measures towards achieving this objective will be included in the budget 2021, in line with its four thrusts, which is caring for the people, steering the economy, sustainable living, and enhancing public service delivery. As part of this consultation, My Creative has conducted a poll since last Thursday on what our creative industry would like to see included in budget 2021. I'm pleased to say that we have since received over 170 responses earlier this morning, and we look forward to more today. Our team will take into consideration and gather all the input. Today, we would like to hear more about the challenges that you face and how the government can help transform and future-proof your business. In addition to actively engaging with the creative economy participants, we need to also look at encouraging other stakeholders, including and especially the private sector, to contribute to its growth. For instance, I hope to hear the feedback from the corporate community on how we can encourage them to be significant supporters of the creative economy, whether it's through tax incentive or other initiatives. On that note, I look forward to a productive session. Thank you.